Yeah, Rod, late this afternoon, the Annapolis Fire Department did release the cause of that fire. It was a smoking product dropped accidentally. Now, whenever you have a fire down here in historic downtown Annapolis, it is a big deal because it can spread just so quickly.
It was a four-alarm fire, drawing a major response from several area departments. Dominique Moyer owns most of the damaged building space.
Saturday, I was down the street at Karen James Studio getting my hair cut, and someone came in and said there's a fire in one of the buildings up the street.
Next door at the smoke shop, the damage will take a long time to clean up.
Pretty well insured, so I mean, I'm going to have a loss of income and everything like that, and, you know, we'll place some merchandise and just, you know, it's going to affect me in the way that I'll just spend a lot of time cleaning.
But given how close together the buildings are down here, the feeling today is one of relief, knowing what could have happened here.
It would have been much worse, yes. Conditions were right for it to be much worse. It was very dry. It was very windy. The fire departments of the Naval Academy, the city, the county were extraordinary. They got here so, so fast and worked right through the afternoon into the evening.
In a lot of downtown, it's a pretty major worry. Our building is actually relatively new. It was rebuilt in 1990, so it actually had a two-hour firewall, and with the wind the way it was, probably prevented it spreading a lot more quickly than it could have.
This is only the third four-alarm fire in historic downtown Annapolis in the last 20 years. Live in Annapolis, John Sherman, WBAL-TV 11 News.